Hello all. In this lecture, we will see about structured data, semi-structured data, and unstructured data. So this is a small topic. So we have different kinds of data. So we'll be seeing about the different kinds of data and also the difference between these data and all. This is a small lecture. So data we have already seen in the previous lecture. So data is something, it is known facts that can be recorded and have an implicit meaning. There will be some meaning also. So those things that can be, those facts that can be recorded. For example, your name, your address, your phone number, all these are data. And it can be descriptions, observations, and numbers used in decision making. It can be anything. And nowadays we have this big data. So we have already seen the history of database applications and all. There we have mentioned that now recently we have this big data kind of thing. So it includes huge volume and huge velocity, or extensible variety of data. It contains large amount of data. It can be of different types. So it can be videos, it can be MP3 files, MP4 files, MKV files, like that. There are different kinds of data, variety of data is there. So big data deals with all this variety of data. So we have to classify this data into different types of data. So we have structured data, then we have semi-structured data and unstructured data. So this is a classification of data. So when nowadays when we use this big data and all, we have to deal with all this kind of data. You will be using this text files, you will be using Excel files, you will be using PDF files, you will be using movie files, all are data. So you need to store all these kind of data. So we need to classify this data first. We have structured data, semi-structured data, and unstructured data. So we will see each one separately. First one is structured data. So structured data is data whose elements are addressable for effective analysis. So those elements which can be addressable are known as structured data. So we can simply say like we have some tabular data. It has which has good organized manner. If you take an Excel sheet, when you save something, you will have a table like structure. So such kind of data is known as addressable data. So this kind of data is known as structured data. So these are addressable. So it is organized into a formatted repository. Example, a database. It is actually formatted. We know the rows, the columns, what is a column name, all these things. It is formatted. So it is known as structured data. It concerns all data which can be stored in database structured query language in a table with rows and columns. So if we can store it in a table with rows and columns, then we can call it as a structured data. They have some keys, we will give you some field for that, we will give for some names for that. For example, if you want to store the name Alan, that name will be the field name, and you will have some constraints on it. You will be specifying that name should be of character type, like that. You can specify different kinds of things. So then it is known as structured data. You will have relational keys, and it can be easily mapped into pre-designed fields. If we design some fields, all those fields can be designed. So there will be some name for all these fields. Then it is known as structured data. Example for the structured data is relational data. So we'll be studying about relational database management system all through this lectures. All through these lectures, we'll be studying mainly about this relational data. So this is an example for structured data. We have different three tables. So this is all organized. We have ID, name, and age. So all these are connected. We have another table, student ID, subject ID, grade. We have another table, ID, subject, and teacher. So all these are connected. So this two is this two, like that. There is some link and all. We have a particular structure. All those fields are, which is well organized. So this is known as structured data. So this is a relation, this is a relation, this is another relation. We call it a stable or relation. So you'll be learning all these things later. So this is a structured data. Then we have second kind of data, which is known as semi-structured data. So semi-structured data. So it is information that does not reside in a relational database. That is, we cannot have this relational database kind of thing. And they have some organizational properties that make it easier to analyze. They have some organization kind of things like the structured data, but altogether it cannot be like the structured data. It can have some organization also. So with some processing, you can store them in a relational database, and it may be sometimes it will be very hard to store this kind of data in a relational database also. So with some process you can store them in a relational database. It is not always the case. In some cases it will be very hard to store such kind of semi-structured data in a relational database also. These are some examples: XML data, the JavaScript, JSON notation, object notation, HTML files, all are considered as semi-structured data. So this is an example. So this is an example for a JSON file. This is an example for XML file. So these are all semi-structured data. There is some kind of structure. There is a semi-structure. It is not fully relations. We cannot directly store this data onto tables. We have to do additional processing. Generally, we can store this in some relational format and all. So this kind of data is known as semi-structured data. Then the third kind of data is unstructured data. So it is a data which is not organized in a predefined manner or does not have any predefined data model. We do not have any data model, and it is not good fit, does not have a predefined data model, and it is not a good fit for mainstream relational data. We cannot store this kind of data in a relational database at all. So it is, there is no structure at all. We cannot store it in the relational database which we are going to study. So for examples of this data type, so it is used by organizations in variety of business intelligence, analytical applications, all these kind of things we will be using this kind of data. So example may be a Word document, a PDF file, or a text file, or it can be media, multimedia, all this. If you take this audio files, all this will form the unstructured data. Or movie files, MP3, MP4, MP, all these files. Then if you take MPKV files, all these files are known as unstructured data. So we need to store all this kind of data. Nowadays, when big data, all when we are using all this kind of data, we have to use this data to store all these things. But we will be mainly studying, focusing on relational database management system, that is to store structured data. But we have other data like semi-structured and unstructured data. So these are some of the examples: Word, PDF, text, media logs, Excel, all these will be unstructured data. So this is an example. This is maybe a PDF file. So we have some textual data. We have some images also. Inside this image, we have something here. So this kind of thing cannot be stored in a particular table. So we require some other thing to store this kind of unstructured data. Okay. So that's all about all these three kinds of data. In structured data, there is high degree of organization. In semi-structure, there will be some organization. And unstructured, there is no predefined organization. If we simply say that structured data, it's like a spreadsheet or Excel kind of thing. There is a tabular format. In semi-structured, you can take, well, say it's like some, there will be some headers, some paragraph like that, XML files. Or HTML files, or all are semi-structured data. In the case of unstructured, there is nothing at all. Everything which is not structured and structured are known as the data which is not structured and semi-structured are known as unstructured data. So we have images, JPEG images, PNG files, video files, MP4, M4A, then sound files like WAV files, MP3. It can be plain text files, Word files, PDF files, all this form these files. This unstructured data. Okay, so that's the difference between these three kinds of data. So I'm sure this is a simple table to show that the difference between structured and unstructured. So in structured data, it can be displayed in rows, columns, and relational databases. So we can format in a table like this. Here in unstructured data, it cannot be displayed in rows, columns, those kind of thing. And also in relational databases, we cannot store this thing. Then numbers, dates, and strings are examples. Here images, audio, video, all these comes. Then 20% of the enterprise data will form the structured data. But 80% of the enterprise, if you take an organization, 80% of the data is like this. And we need to analyze, we need to store this PDF and all for data analysis. If you want to calculate the stock market prediction, or if we want to do some manipulations, or if we want to calculate some data analysis kind of thing, we require this unstructured data. Then only, so 80% of the data is unstructured. Then we require only less storage, because almost all are like this table kind of thing. Here it requires more storage. We have to store all these kind of files. Then it is easier to manage and protect with legacy solutions, but it is more difficult to manage and protect from this data. So these are the differences. So this is actually the characteristics of based on this key properties. We can classify all this data based on technology. If we can say the structured data is based on relational database table, we will be studying about relational database systems. It is based on XML, or we call it as RDF, resource description framework. It is based on character and binary data. All this found files, all this form of the unstructured data. Then if we take transaction management, we have already seen what is a transaction. It is some instructions. So it is mature transaction and has some concurrency techniques. Here, transaction is adapted from DBMS, but not matured like the structured data. All those concurrency management, which is very difficult to do all these things and all. Here, no transaction management and no concurrency at all. There is no concurrency management. We cannot adopt all these things because PDF, lot of people will be accessing the same PDF at a time. Then version management. So here, versioning can be done over rows or over tables can be done. Here also, versioning over rows, over tuples. Tuples means actually rows. We will be studying about this tuples and all. Or graph is also possible if we are using some graph kind of data. We will be seeing all these things later. Then versioned as a whole. So the whole document will be versioned, or the whole video file will be versioned. We cannot version a particular frame. That is, we cannot fix that this frame can be modified by some person. We cannot say that. The whole video file, if you want, you can edit, and again you can do it here. But we can change a particular row, or we can change a particular table. Everything is possible. Flexibility. It is schema dependent. We will see what is schema in the next lecture. And it is less flexible. Here it is more flexible than structured data, but less flexible than unstructured. Here it is more flexible and there is absence of schema. There is no particular rules and all. Anything can be done. Scalability. When you consider the scalability, it is very difficult to scale this DBMS schema. In the case of here, it is scaling is simpler than structured data. It is more scalable. Then based on query performance, we have missed the last point. Anyway, it is actually based on query performance. Queries, when we write this query, structured query, here in the case of structured data, structured query allow complex joining. If you want to have complex joining and all, it is possible. Here in semi-structured data, queries over anonymous nodes are possible. We will not be studying about the semi-structured data and unstructured data. Then for the, in the case of unstructured data, only textual queries are possible. Here only textual queries. Here, structured query allow complex joining of all these things can be done using this query. So query optimization, everything can be done here. All these things will happen. So we will be mainly dealing with the structured data. And in the last module, we'll be learning a little bit about this unstructured database. So here, in this all these lectures, we'll be mainly dealing with structured data. That is, the data which can be stored in some tables. So these are the references. You can see this I have taken from, actually it's not available in a textbook. I have taken from this Geeks for Geeks site and also from K2 Academy, and you can refer online websites to take this these three data. Thank you.